Almost at the beginning of every song, mm-hmm. you hear, "Law Night, you rolling?" And I go, "Yep." And then you hear him go, the Zippo, clink.
The winter cream, the juniper, the cornflower and the chicory. Well, all of the words you said to me are still vibrating in my head. The elm ash and the linden tree, the dark and deep enchanted sea, the trembling moon and the stars unfurl. Oh, there she goes, my beautiful world. 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 There she goes again.
The great fear is, I think, when you're creating any form of art, is that you repeat yourself and you always want to try and go somewhere else.
There's two albums. One's called Abattoir Blues, one's called The Lyre of Orpheus. We've kept the two records quite separate. Jim Sclavounis, who's a very heavy drummer, drums basically all the way through Abattoir Blues, so it is a much heavier record. And The Lyre of Orpheus, which has Thomas, who's lighter and more jazzy, drumming through that, so that's lighter and quieter. Blixer left the band, James joined. That had an untold influence. The real differences with this record is that we actually went to Paris about 6 months before recording it. I took Warren Ellis, the violin player, Jim Sclavounis, the drummer, and Martin Casey, the bass player, to a tiny little studio in Paris as a songwriting event.
I mean, I have to say, Warren did some great stuff on this album. He's doing a lot of sounds where you go, what is that? He's playing bouzouki, mandolin, violin. He's playing a lot of different instruments. Even when I was mixing, I'd write down the instruments. You know, you'd have the Warren Ellis section of the desk where there'd be all his instruments.
A lot of the time we would just sit there and I'd call out 1, 2, 3, 4 without any instruction whatsoever and everyone would plow into something.
Get ready for love!
Worked for like 5 days. And when an idea ran out, it was like, right, where do we find another one? We just started up this riff and just started hammering along, and then, you know, next thing, Nick just launched into this tirade of words, you know, it just went on and on and on like this, you know, and we were all just going, bashing away. It was all really exciting and stuff. And at the end, he remarked after we did it, he said, you know, that was something he could never do on his own, having something that was just like rolling along underneath him enabled him to go off in a different way with the words, I guess. And I hadn't really ever been involved in a session like that with him, so it was fantastic just to see the way he could just throw words together like that.
The great thing about this album for Mick Harvey in particular was that a lot of things that he would usually have had to have taken care of, you know, I took on the role of taking care of those things, so it gave him more freedom to just be a musician and play guitar. So his guitar playing on this album, I think, is great, and I think he said that to me a few times, that he said he really enjoyed playing. The thing about Nick that you have to realise is he's very funny. My main image of Nick during this album is all him smiling and laughing a lot and being very cheeky and very naughty.
I think I can speak for all of the members of the group that it was actually really enjoyable doing it.
Well, I'm down in bed with the Eskimos, with the polar bears and the Arctic snow, where the party of penguins are who do not know how I can get back to thee. Well, I'm gonna ask you, babe,
This time he was quite confident. He was like, I'm really happy with these lyrics and I think I've got some really good songs. And I was like, well, how many do you want to do? And he said, well, I've got like 20-something songs. I'm like, wow, you know, do you want to record them all? Well, I'd like to, you know, have a go at them all and we'll see. At that point, we hadn't decided it was a double album. We just knew there were a lot of songs. So me and Mick talked, you know, between various conversations to decide that we should actually rehearse.
That's a major step forward for us, because getting the Bad Seed to a rehearsal is often an extremely difficult thing to do. I think it helped get towards a sound, I think, that we've been trying to get for a long time, actually. I guess the rhythm track is completely understood, but what else is going on is very much improvised. To me, this record really, all the songs really mean a lot, and I feel I've really worked hard on them. You know, I've listened to it a lot, and it just sounds really good.
Conway, he went out and played on this song called Babe You Turn Me On. One take, he played this part that was so perfect for this song. I remember Nick was sitting next to me and we were like, looking at each other going, that's it. If he only played on that one song, his role in this album was complete. But he played on other songs.
Nature Boy was a song that we all wrote at these Paris sessions. We just struck that up and started playing it. It was catchy, and I think it reminded everyone of Come Up and See Me by Cockney Rebel, which we're all huge fans of course. There was something that was just very contagious about the whole thing. But it's a piece of straight pop, and it was kind of exciting to do that, really.
The news on TV. I saw some ordinary slaughter, I saw some routine atrocity. My father said, don't look away, you gotta be strong, you gotta be bold now. He said that in the end it is beauty that is gonna save the world now. And she moves among the sparrows. As she flows upon the breeze, as she moves upon the flowers, as she moves, something deep inside me. I was walking round the flower show like a leper coming down with some kind of nervous hysteria. I saw you standing there, green eyes, black hair, up against the pink and purple hysteria. You said, hey, Nietzsche boy, you're looking at me with some unrighteous intention. My knees went weak, I couldn't speak, I was having thoughts of one not in my best interest to mention. As you move among the flowers, as you float upon the smoke, as you move among the shadows, as she moves me with just one little look. You took me back to your place and dressed me up in a deep sea diver's suits. You played the patriot, you raised the flag, and I stood at full salute. Well, later on we smoked a pipe, it struck me dumb and made it impossible to speak. As you closed in slow motion, called me Sappho in the original Greek. As she moves among the sparrows, as she walks across the sea,
I understand that not everyone's going to like them. I understand that they're not for everybody, and it takes a certain kind of intestinal sort of fortitude to listen to some of this stuff some of the time. But I love my songs, and or our songs, and but they live on the periphery, and they're always looking in on the other songs. They're, you know, up the back of the bus, huddled up the back of the bus, you know, sniggering at the smoking and sniggering at all the other songs.
All the earthly things they stop to play, for we are all breathless without you. I listen to my jordering bones and the blood in my veins, the wind in my lungs, and I am a breathless without you. Still your hands, still your heart, but still your face comes shining through, and all the morning glows anew. Still your soul, still your mind, but still the fire of the love is true, and I am a breathless